Hello, everyone. Bonjour tout le monde. Thank you to the Association of Faculties of Medicine of Canada for the invitation to share a few words. Merci à l'Association des Facultés de Médecine du Canada de l'invitation à dire quelques mots. I would like to start by acknowledging that Canada is the homeland of First Nations, Inuit, and Métis peoples, and that I am speaking to you from Ottawa on the unceded traditional territory of the Algonquin Anishinaabe people. I'm so pleased to see the important linkages between my work and key themes in your declaration on planetary health. In particular, I appreciate your commitment to health equity and justice. Applying an equity lens can highlight differences in climate health impacts across populations and help shape our responses to minimize the exacerbation of current inequities. Last year, my annual report focused on actions needed now to center health at the heart of climate action. Moving forward, we'll require strong and resilient health systems that can cope with climate change while delivering essential public health and health services. We can do more to keep equity and health promotion at the forefront through more effective intersectoral action and by better equipping our workforce. In your declaration, you too have challenged the health ecosystem by advocating for faculty, staff, and students of academic health institutions to take the Planetary Health Pledge. They will be acknowledging the connection between environmental health and human health and committing to protecting natural systems. This will help push the climate conversation forward into the minds of future health professionals and enable them to take action. The climate crisis has clearly shown the need to link nature, sustainability, and public health. We have much to learn from First Nations, Inuit, and Métis peoples, who have long recognized the interconnections between human health, animal health, and the health of the environment, and how to live sustainably. I was pleased to see your commitment to incorporating Indigenous ways of knowing into your declaration as a meaningful framework to understand these linkages. Academic health institutions have a role to play in fostering Indigenous health research leadership and Indigenous knowledge sovereignty to further enhance research and education within their settings. As we look to address the health impacts of climate change, research and education are crucial to fill existing knowledge gaps. This will allow us to build a strong and resilient health workforce that is well positioned to adapt and respond to the health threats posed by climate change. Through the integration of concepts such as planetary health into education and training, we can promote a better understanding of the far-reaching impacts of climate change on the environmental, social, and structural determinants of health. In this vein, the CPHO annual report has been accompanied by a research opportunities document targeted towards the research community. It can be used to inform evidence generation and scientific priorities, supporting the mobilization of the report's recommendations. Healthcare institutions and professionals can be leaders in taking action against climate change. Your advocacy for reducing healthcare-based emissions and increased sustainability will add momentum to the actions that healthcare institutes must take. As trusted members of communities, health professionals can use their knowledge and leadership to mobilize action from within and outside the health sector. Action brings hope. L'action apporte de l'espoir. Ensemble, nous pouvons continuer à améliorer la santé et le bien-être des personnes au Canada. We've seen over the past few years just how much we can achieve by working together. I strongly encourage you all to keep health equity at the center of your collective efforts to address the complex public health challenges of today and the future. Thank you. Merci. Miigwech.